Hello students, as we have done yesterday with all the properties of square number, and also we have seen some special patterns about it, right? So today we will do the exercise 3.2. See, very first question in this. Write 5 numbers which you can decide by looking at their ones digit that they are not square number. Yesterday we have done with the one of the property in which it was mentioned that a number which is ending by 2, 3, 7 or 8. Any number which are ending by 2 or 3 or 7 or 8, that will never be a perfect square number. So, we can make any number. They are asking for 5 numbers. So, you can write anything like 200. You can write 243. Or 572, because this number is ending by 3, this number is ending by 2, or you can write down directly any number, 2 digit number, 5 digit number, any number you can write, or you can write down 848, number is ending by 8. So any number which is ending by these digits are not a perfect square number. So just you have to see that the last number what you have to write, 1027, these are the numbers which will not be a perfect square number. You will choose by your own these numbers, okay? Yes. Now see the second question. What will be the unit digit of the squares of the following numbers? What will be the unit digit of the squares of the number? Like you have to find square of 329? No. You have to find square of 329, then you get the unit digit. No, directly we can tell what the number will be, the ending number for the square of 329, because what is in the ones place? 9, and 9 square is 81, so ones place will be 1 only. So unit digit of square of 329 will be ending by, will be 1. It will be ending by 1 because of 9. 9 9 is 81. So, the ending will be with 1. You have done this property, right? See for this. This number you are having 95,628. So, number is ending by 8. And square of 8 is ending by which number? 4. Because 8 is 64. So, the number will end by 4. So, unit digit. You always have to see only the one unit digit. So unit digit of square of 95,628 will be 4, because 8 is in the ones place. Now here is 3, 7,643, and 3 square is what? 9. So this number, square of this number will end by 9. So unit place will be, or unit digit of square of 7643 is, or will be, that is your word, will be 9. Here is 7, and 7 7 is again 49. So the ones place will be 9. So unit digit of square of 68,327 will be 9. Okay. The square, see the third question, the square of which of the following numbers would be an odd number or even number and why? See, first number we are having is 573. What is this number? This is even or odd? This is obviously odd number, and we have studied the property that square of odd number is odd and square of even number is even. So this is odd number, so square of odd number will be odd. So directly you can write down square of, or square of this is an odd number. As we have studied what is the property, because square of odd number is odd. You can write the reason. Square of odd number is odd. Okay? And also you can see here which type of number this we are having, 4096. This is an even number. So square of 4096 is even number, as this is an even number and square of even number is even. That is the reason you will write. Okay? Yes, now see the fourth question. How many natural numbers lie between square of the following numbers? Means, how many numbers are lying between 12 square and 13 square? Right? And we have done one property of pattern about it. If n is, what is n here? 12. Right? And what is n plus 1 here? Next consecutive number, that is 13. And numbers lying between 12 square and 13 square will be 2 into 12, that is 2n, right? So numbers, natural numbers lying between 12 square and 13 square will be equal to how much? 2n was the formula. And what is n here? 12. So 2 into 12, that is 24. So 24 number will lie between the squares of 12 and square of 13. Yes. Now see the fifth question. Without adding, find the sum. What number you have to add? See, 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11 plus 13 plus 15. You can see that here we are having consecutive odd numbers, right? And we know, we have done one property. What we have done? We know that the sum of first n natural number, first n natural odd numbers is how much? Is n square. First n odd natural number. See how many odd natural numbers we are having? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We are having first 8 consecutive odd numbers and we have to sum up. So that will be equal to how much? See, 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11 plus 13 plus 15 will be equal to how much? We are having 8 odd terms, consecutive odd terms. So 8 square will be the answer. According to our property we are knowing. So 8 square is how much? 64. So without summing up, we can know the answer for it. Okay. Now see the sixth one. Express the following as the sum of two consecutive integers. 15 square is the number we are having. So you have done one property also. 15 square is how much you know? That is equal to 225. Right. So now we have to express 225 as the sum of two consecutive integers. And for that, what I told you, you have to find the first number. What is the first number? That will be equal to 225 divided by 2. All of you know how to divide. When you divide this by 2, what you will get? 2 ones are 2. Then again 2 ones are 2. And then 2 twos are 4. So whatever quotient you are getting, 112. So first number will be the quotient whatever you are getting, right? And second number will be the consecutive number of the quotient. What is the next number after 112? You will get 113. 13, and when you add these two terms, so you'll get 225. Hence, 15 square can be written as 112 plus 113. Okay. Now see the seventh one. Find the square of the following numbers containing 5 in units place. What number we are having? 305. We have to find the square of this number. So we have done one property for this also. 305 square will be equal to what? Just before the 5, what number we are having? 30. So 30 multiplied by. After 30, what is coming? 31. So consecutive number for 30 is 31. Hundreds. Plus 25. You have done this property. Whatever number is there before 5, that number multiplied by its consecutive number. And then that's hundreds plus 25 is the answer for that. So 30 multiplied by 31 will give you how much? 390. 930 and 100. So multiply by 100, so you get 93,000 plus 25. So you know how to add it down. So 930 and 25. This will be your answer. Okay. Write Pythagorean triplet whose one number is 18. So, what I told you, one number is there, if even number is there, so we can go for, we can suppose this number as 2m. Or one thing more I told you, if the number given is successor or predecessor of a square number. So, 80 is predecessor of 81, which is a square number, and it is also an even number. So, we can go in two ways. See, suppose if I have taken 80 as a predecessor of a square number. So what I suppose? Let m square minus 1 is equal to 80 because this is a predecessor of a square number. So I suppose m square minus 1 equal to 80. From here what I will get? M square is equal to 80 plus 1, that is 81. So m is equal to how much? 9. Right? M square minus 1 I am having. So what is the other number we will find? 2m. I need to find the value for 2m. That is 2m will be 2 into 9. And that will be equal to 9 2 is 18. And third number what I have to find? M square plus 1. Because I am already having m square minus 1. So m square plus 1. That will be equal to m square is how much? 81. So 81 plus 1 will give you how much? 82. So what numbers I got? First number is 18, 2m. Second number is m square minus 1, that is 80. And third number is 82. So this is Pythagorean triplet I got. Pythagorean triplet. That is the first method what we should do, right? Otherwise, if suppose one child has thought, ma'am, you told that 80 is an even number. So what he can suppose? He can also do like, he can suppose let 2m is equal to 80 because 80 is an even number and we can get the value for m here also. So m is equal to 80 divided by 2, that will be 40. And what is the second term I have to find? M square minus 1, right? So what will be the m square? M is 40. So square of 40 minus 1. Right? 40 square is equal to how much? 4 square is 16. So with 2 zero. 1600 minus 1. So my number will be 1599. That is the m square minus 1. And now what next I have to find? M square plus 1. That will be equal to m square. We got as 1600. So 1600 plus 1, so your answer will be 1601. So from here you can get one another set of Pythagorean triplet. What will be that? 80 first number, second number is 1599 and third number is 1601. So that is your choice. You can find this. Here is also 80 So you can get three set of numbers like 18, 80 and 82 as a Pythagorean triplet. Or if we have suppose like this, so you can get 80, 1599 and 1601. This is also a Pythagorean triplet. Okay. Now finding the square root. Find the square root of 7056 by prime factorization. So as the name is already saying that prime factorization we have to do. So first we have to do for the prime factorization of 7056. All of you know how to do the prime factorization. So 2. 2 3 is 6. 2 5 is 10. 2 2 is 4. And 2 8 is 16. Right? So again 2. 2 1 is 2. 2 7 is 14. 2 6 is 12. 2 4 is 8. Again 2. 2 8 is 16. 2 8 is 16. And 2 2 is 4. 2 4 is 8. 2 4 is 8. 2 1 is 2. 4 plus 4 plus 1 is 9. So it will go by 3. 3 1 is 3. 3 4 is 12. 3 7 is 21. Again 3. 3 4 is 12. And 3 9 is 27. So again 7 7 is 49. And 7 1 is 7. So we have done with the prime factorization. 7056 is equal to, write the prime factorization for this. How many times 4, 2 is coming? 4 times. So 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. Again multiply by 3 into 3 and 7 into 7. So let's check, we are having the pairing of the same prime numbers. 2, 2, 1 pair is there, 2, 2, 1 pair is there, 3 and 3, 1 pair is there, and 7 and 7, 1 pair is there. So all the factors are paired. So it is a perfect square, and now we have to find the root value, square root of 7056. To get the square root of 7056, what we have to do, from each pair we have to take only one term. So this is a pair of 2, so only one time 2 will take it out, right? Again we got a pair of 2, so again 1, 2 will come down. Next we got a pair of 3, so 1, 3 will come down. Next is a pair of 7, so 7 will come down. So what we got, 7, 3 is 21 and 21 into 4. 21 into 4 will go for 84. So square root of 7056 is 84. So these type of questions we will see to find the square roots of different numbers. Okay.